Zealand naturopath Eric Backer, thanks for coming back. We've talked about walking and losing weight. So an interesting study was conducted in 2002, that's a long time ago now, and what they found was interesting. They found that walking certainly helped, but it worked a lot better in changing, you know, many aspects of the human health variables like cholesterol and weight and, you know, waist circumference. The people had a far better outcome when they combined diet and exercise as just diet alone. They also found slightly better averages from people who walk daily, like 30 minutes a day, as opposed to, like, you know, once or twice a week, like a 1 hour session of walking. So there's no doubt about it. You don't have to always walk to lose weight. You can just be an active person like me. I spend a lot of time in the garden. So, and I make sure that I do a lot of walking and bending and stretching. And I've got friends my age who do yoga and who do running and cycling and all sorts of things. And, well, I quite like those kind of activities, but I prefer gardening because, you know, I get a lot of bang for my buck. I mean, I get tons and tons of produce out of the garden, and we get lots of honey and we get lots of fruit. And the benefit for me, of course, is fitness, flexibility and strength. Try and find some activity that you enjoy doing. It doesn't have to be walking, but being active is one of the key things that I really try and impress on people throughout their lives. Being physically active. Trying to be a bit socially active, you know, and activity is the key, because when you start sitting down and clicking these mice all the time and playing games and, you know, and all you're doing is using your eyes and your brain a bit, you're not really using your body, and you're going to get what we call the sitting disease. So it's also a good idea for you maybe to get a fitness tracker, and one of my patients recently used it to great advantage as like a relaxation tracker, because he could work out at what the quality of his sleep was like and how much time he was sitting down as opposed to moving around. So fitness trackers aren't just for people to get them off their butt. Sometimes they're also good to get people on their butt that do too much. But either way, if you do something like that, you know, you're going to monitor, you know, how many steps you take. One of my kids put, and my phone cover's not good, you can see I've been painting. One of my kids put a step kind of tracker on this phone and said to me, if you put your phone in your pocket all the time, you can track how many steps you take. But I don't like walking around with these phones in my pocket all the time. And I did for just a small part of the day, and it was 3,000 steps. And I only had it in my pocket for a small amount of time. So I'm probably well exceeding the 10,000 steps a day. But you can get a pedometer, a little thing that clips onto your sock or your shoe also, that will show you, you know, how many steps you're taking. But being active and having a good diet, in my opinion, are the key things in when it comes to trying to, you know, get those human variables in line. If you want good cholesterol levels, you want nice blood pressure, if you want your insulin sensitivity not to be too high, you know what I mean? If you want to reduce your risk of cancer and heart disease, get off your butt. Start walking. It makes all the difference in the world, okay? But it doesn't mean to say walk to the refrigerator more or walk to the pantry more. Try and walk outside more, because then you're away from food. Makes a difference. Don't forget to click on the link below if you want my free Candida report. Thanks for tuning in.